Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Let's start the MCQs in English for the day 10th of July 2018. Who has become the second Indian? He is the only second Indian mountaineer to climb Mount Ojos del Salado, which is the world's highest volcano. Now let me tell you about Mount Ojos del Salado. It is more than 6000 meters in height and it is located at the border of Chile and Argentina in South America. It is a part of Andes mountain range, which is the largest mountain range in the world, even more than the mighty Himalayas. The first person to do so was Malia Mastan Babu. And the second person is Satya Roop Siddhant. He is from Bengaluru, Karnataka. And also remember that this particular volcano is the world's highest and it is located in between a desert which is called Atacama Desert. Atacama Desert. So keep that in mind. Britain's Brexit minister David Davis has recently resigned. Which party does he belong to? So he has resigned from the Conservative Party. Conservative Party is actually the ruling party in Britain. So therefore the British Prime Minister Theresa May, she is from Conservative Party. And of late there has been a resurgence of the Labour Party. So things are looking tough now for Conservative Party. Now Conservative Party has decided to have good relations with the European Union even after Brexit. And that is what led to the resign of David Davis. Which country has given rights to regular citizens and non-government organizations to sue or to subject them to a lawsuit polluting companies in civil courts as per a new bill proposal approved in that country? Which basically means that even if I am an ordinary citizen and if I come across any company that is polluting the environment, I can drag that company to court. This has been done by the government of Israel for environment conservation. Israel, the currency is called shekel. And Benjamin Netanyahu is the Prime Minister and Jerusalem is the capital. Which country is conducting the DNA test, deoxyribose nucleic acid, which is the genetic material in our cells, that is called DNA. Its structure was discovered by Watson and Crick. Watson and Crick are the name of the scientist who discovered the structure of DNA, which is a double helical structure. So DNA test of more than 3000 children will be conducted to reunite them with their parents. And as you must have inferred by now that these 3000 children are the children of the refugees and migrants. So this is of course America. America's vice president is Mike Pence and America's defense minister is James Mattis and secretary of state is Mike Pompeo. Who has been appointed as the acting manager of the National Film Development Corporation called NFDC in short? His name is Manoj Kumar Pingua. Two more people are important if I am talking about films. One is who is the chairman of the censor board, also called Central Censor Board of Film Certification. So it is Prasoon Joshi. And FTII, Film and Television Institute of India, FTII chairman is Anupam Kher. Now Anupam Kher is also acting in a movie called The Accidental Prime Minister, and it is basically a book written by Sanjay Baru, and he is playing the role of Manmohan Singh. Which state government has announced that it will enroll nomadic tribes for the Aadhaar card? This is being done so that there can be a database that can be generated, because nomadic tribes are those which they wander from one place to another in search of food and agriculture. They practice jhum cultivation or shifting cultivation most of the times, and they basically just wander from one place to another. So this decision has been taken by the government of Haryana. What is the prescribed noise level of the airports with more than 50,000 aircraft per year, that is the takeoff or landing during daytime, as per the new rules decided by the Environment Ministry? So basically rephrase the question. So there are two types of airports. Okay, one is a small airport which have like between 15,000 to 50,000 flights every day, takeoff landing included, right? 50,000 per year actually, including all the days of the year, 365. And one airport is which has more than 50,000. Right. So more than 50,000, these are the biggest airports in India, like the Mumbai airport, the Indira Gandhi International Airport and so on. So for these, the noise level is 75 and 65 respectively. 75 is during the daytime and 65 is during the night time. I repeat once more, for the biggest airports in India, that is which have more than 50,000 flights per year, right, including all the 365 days. So during daytime it is 75, night time it is 65. So the answer to this question, they are asking more than 50,000 aircraft per year, the answer is up to 75, right? But if I talk about the smaller airports where we have 15,000 to 50,000 flights every year, the noise level is 65 and 60, right? 65 is during daytime and 60 is during night time. So accordingly, you have to mark the answer. And our environment minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. Which Indian warship reached Sri Lanka for goodwill tour? So basically, one of our ships has gone to Sri Lanka. This is on a goodwill tour. It is Indian naval ship INS Trikand. However, there are a few more ships that you need to remember. They were in news in the last 2 to 3 months. Malabar exercise, which is an exercise between India, Japan and the US. Three Indian ships participated. INS Sayadri, INS Komorta and INS Shakti. Now remember, INS Sayadri is named after Sayadri, and Sayadri is nothing but the name of Western Ghats in India. Western Ghats are also called the Sayadris. RIMPAC exercise, where China was not invited. Remember, China was not invited in RIMPAC, and RIMPAC took place in Hawaii. From India, INS Sayadri went once again. Now in Yemen, lot of Indians were stranded because of cyclone. So they were stranded on Socotra Island. So Indian government conducted Operation Nistar to rescue them for the search and rescue operations. And INS Sunaina went to Yemen. Capital of Yemen is Sana'a. And INSV Tarin, it is a basically advanced boat which was used in the circumnavigation of the earth, Navika Sagar Parikrama, by the 6 women brave officers of the Indian Navy. 17th World Sanskrit Conference, which is basically to promote Sanskrit language, which is said to be the the first language of the world, and various languages have taken origin from the Sanskrit language, as it is said in India. It was inaugurated by the HRD Minister Prakash Javadekar. He is the Minister for Human Resource Development. In which country has the inauguration taken place? This has taken place in Canada. Canada's capital is Ottawa, and there is a place in Canada called Montreal, which is the headquarter of WADA, World Anti-Doping Agency. Also in Canada, 2 6 are very important. One is Jagmeet Singh. He will challenge Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister, for the PM post next year in elections. So his party is New Democratic Party. And Defence Minister is Harjit Singh. Defence Minister of Canada is Harjit Singh. Reserve Bank of India has cancelled the license of which urban cooperative bank, which because it was not following the proper rules and regulations. In fact, those people who were making a deposit, it was not able to pay them back. So this bank is Alwar Urban Cooperative Bank. Now let me also tell you that 11 banks have been put under prompt corrective action by Reserve Bank of India. 11 banks. And these banks are shutting down their ATM fast. And out of all these 11 banks, the bank that has shut down maximum number of ATMs is Indian Overseas Bank. What is the name of the novel for which Michael Ondaatje's he has won Golden Man Booker Prize at the South Bank Center in London? Now here I will tell you three questions which can be asked. So there is an award, literary award, called the Man Booker Prize. The Man Booker Prize, for the last 50 years, this award has now completed 50 years. So we selected something known as the best booker of all time. That is the, which is called the Golden Man Booker Prize. That is the bookers of bookers, you know, it's like that. So out of, in the last 50 years, whoever has won the Booker Prize, which one has been the best? So this was given to the book English Patient, written by Michael Ondaatje. Now two more questions. If they ask who was the first Indian to win Booker Prize, the answer is Arundhati Roy for the book The God of Small Things. And last year she also wrote a book called The Ministry of Utmost Happiness. If they ask you who was the first Indian origin person to win a Booker Prize, now there is a difference. Indian and Indian origin is different. Indian origin is when one of the parents is Indian, right? So V.S. Naipaul, the great V.S. Naipaul, who has also won the Nobel Prize in Literature, he was the first Indian origin person. He was not born in India. He was born in Trinidad and Tobago. He was born in Trinidad and Tobago. So he was the first person of Indian origin to win a Booker Prize for his novel In a Free State. But the first Indian was Arundhati Roy, right? Who will lead the men's hockey team in the Asian Games? Asian Games will take place in Indonesia, right? They will take place in Indonesia. So who will lead the men's hockey team? The female hockey team will be led by Rani Rampal, and men's hockey team will be led by P.R. Srijesh. P.R. Srijesh is from Kanyakumari. He is from Tamil Nadu, and he is also the goalkeeper of the Indian hockey team. Who won the bronze medal for India at the 2018 IWF Junior World Weightlifting Championship, which was held in the capital of Uzbekistan, Tashkent? Her name is Jhilli Dal Bahera. Jhilli Dal Bahera, and she is from Odisha. Chytrid fungus. So it is a fungus. Fungus, you know, they are multicellular organisms which have saprophytic nutrition. They decompose and decay. They don't do photosynthesis. And fungus, they spread many diseases. So one of the fungus is chytrid fungus. It is the cause of lethal skill diseases to which species of the Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, Himalayas, Northeast Hill Ranges and Andaman and Nicobar Island, and all of these are very high biodiversity areas. So they are a serious threat to frog. Now let me tell you, they cause skin diseases in frog, and in the past also many a time they have been responsible, the chytrid fungus have been responsible for elimination of frogs, you know. Which state government is set to announce compulsory retirement? So basically this state has 16 lakh employees, 1.6 million. And out of 16 lakh, 4 lakh are above the age of 50. And if they don't perform well, then they will be forced to retire. That is what this state is contemplating. It is Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh will enforce compulsory retirement for people who are above the age of 50 if they are found negligent towards their work. Which river originates from Amarkantak? Amarkantak is a place in Madhya Pradesh. It is one of our very holy pilgrimages in the central India. And Narmada takes its origin from there. Also, there is another river called Son. Son river also takes its origin from Amarkantak. Now, Narmada, you know that it falls into the Arabian Sea, and river Son joins Ganga. Which is the world's largest freshwater lake out of these four? World's largest freshwater lake is the Lake Superior. When do we observe the World Environment Day? It is observed on June the 5th. Coming back to current affairs, in which state the Prime Minister has led the foundation of 13 projects worth 2100 crore recently? He was on a visit to this state in Jaipur, the capital, which is also called the Pink City. I am talking about Rajasthan. There are various projects like the elevated road projects, like the establishment of sewage treatment plants, the drinking water schemes. This state, by the way, has something known as Jal Swavalamban Abhiyan, which means we will become self-sufficient in water, you know. So self-sustaining. So this is called Jal Swavalamban Abhiyan. It is a flagship scheme of the government of Rajasthan. And these are the four smart cities that will be built in Rajasthan under the smart cities mission. Jaipur, Udaipur, Kota and Ajmer. Kota is located on the bank of Chambal River. Okay, Chambal River, which is a tributary of Yamuna. And Rajasthan, Kalyan Singh is the governor and Vasundhara Raja is the CM. Also remember, there will be 100 smart cities that will be built in India. And the 100th smart city which was announced recently was Shillong, capital of Meghalaya. With which state government has the British Council signed a memorandum of understanding to promote cultural, educational and skill development? All. Our Minister for Skill Development is Dharmender Pradhan. He is also the Minister for Oil and Gas. And this state is West Bengal. Governor is Kesarinath Tripathi. And of course, Mamata Banerjee is the CM. Which state government released the policy document of the 5-year jackfruit mission on the occasion of the jackfruit festival? Jackfruit is an important fruit. It was recently declared by Kerala as their state fruit. And recently, the government of Meghalaya has announced a jackfruit mission for 5 years. Meghalaya, Ganga Prasad is the governor and Conrad Sangma is the chief minister. Also remember, there is a fruit called Queen Pineapple. Queen Pineapple, it was announced as the state fruit by Tripura government recently. Which administration of Uttar Pradesh has launched an Android-based smartphone application which is called Stop JE, Japanese Encephalitis or Acute Encephalitis Syndrome, to combat encephalitis? This mobile app will provide all the information related to the disease. It will help the patients get all the necessary information. It has been done by the Gorakhpur administration. Who has been appointed as a member of the Broadcasting Content Complaints Council? It works under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, headed by Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore, who is also the Sports Minister of India. His name is Uday Kumar Verma. He is a member. Our Home Minister Rajnath Singh, he will chair the 67th plenary of the Northeastern Council. This session has been arranged at which place? He recently flew to Shillong to attend the session. So it will take place in Shillong, capital of Meghalaya, and also the 100th smart city. Now there is a ministry also which is called Development of Northeastern Region, and it is headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. Which city is to have a wall of nearly 31 lakh native trees encircling it soon to shield it from the frequent dust storms coming from Rajasthan? Because what happens is, when these dust storms come, then the quality of the air, which is already very in dire straits in this city, it becomes further degraded and leading to huge jump in the PM 2.5 and PM 10 particulate matter particles, which is very dangerous for your lungs. So Delhi will have 3.1 million trees. Now it will have a wall. So 3.1 million trees will be planted around Delhi to protect it from the dust storms coming from Rajasthan. The Environment Ministry has issued a notification declaring 438 square kilometer of area around the Mudumalai Tiger Reserve in Nilgiri Hills as an eco-sensitive zone, right? And by declaring eco-sensitive zone, the government is very clear that they don't want to allow any construction here, no human activity, very limited human activity, so that the Tiger Reserve has a lot of buffer area, right? So this has been declared as eco-sensitive zone. This reserve, Mudumalai Tiger Reserve, is located in which state? It is located in Tamil Nadu, in the beautiful Nilgiri Hills. Senior Congress leader M.M. Jacob, he died recently. He was the governor of which state? He was a senior Congress leader, Rajya Sabha member of parliament also, and he was the governor of Meghalaya also. Now, Mizoram is the only state in Northeast which has a Congress government right now. Which harmful chemical has been found in the fishes of Tamil Nadu for the first time? Now, the public of Kerala, the fishermen of Kerala, they have said they will not buy fish from Tamil Nadu, because in Tamil Nadu fishes, a very harmful chemical is found for the first time. It is formalin. Very, very dangerous. Cancer causing. If you eat the fish. So if you are watching this video and if you are from Tamil Nadu, do avoid eating fish for the next few months, because formalin is very, very dangerous for your liver, for your kidney. And formalin is produced when formaldehyde, it dissolves in water. So this was the video for 10th of July. I hope you liked my questions. And there were 29 questions. So do share your score also if it is worthy of sharing. Thank you so much.